Okay, now I want to talk about the offer for your seed launch. So first of all, you do not have to do all this. I've got a laundry list here for you. These are just, just go through here and pick and choose. You don't have to do it all, so please don't get intimidated. I just gave you this list for brainstorming purposes. First of all, teleseminars or webinars I see as being a real key part of the seed launch. You definitely want to survey after each one, ask people, what questions they are on the topic that you had the last time. So, like if you're teaching about guitar and you taught, did a module or a teleseminar, which will probably end up becoming a module, and it's about how to tune your guitar, then say, hey folks, our last call was about learning how to tune your guitar. Could you tell me what you need, what questions you still have about tuning the guitar? And so you send them to a survey. And then at the survey, you should tell them what the next topic is going to be and ask them for questions they have about that topic. Say, thanks a lot for telling us about, what you thought about that last seminar. Our next one is going to be about playing the D chord. What do I need to cover about playing the D chord? Please let me know so I can be sure to cover everything that you're wondering about. So surveys are real key. Sometimes I get a question, could you just do this as a video and release a video, each week or as each module? And you can certainly do that. I just think with the seed launch, doing it live interactively is generally a higher perceived value, not always, but usually. And so I would go with the teleseminar or the webinar. Guest experts, you can, if you don't have the knowledge about something and you want to do a product about it, if you want to do a seed launch about it, then you can just line up a series of experts and interview them, or you can add in interviews with people as a bonus or to fill out the offer. Like I told you how I did it with the Product Lunch Workshop. I, did a series of webinars, actually teleseminars, and then I also had several interviews. So that's a way to round out your offer. These could be live calls or they could be recorded. Here I've got a typo that says webinars. They could be live or they could be recorded ahead of time with the expert. Generally, live is going to have a higher perceived value. You could do hot seats. Basically, that's where if someone is working on something, then you could have them turn in their work and then you could go through their work and give them suggestions. And so this is sort of a participation type of thing. People love this. If they're wondering how to write a resume, if you're teaching how to write a resume, they can send you the resume and you can go through their resume and make tweaks and show them what you would do differently. That's a hot seat. It could be you could supplement your offer, your teleseminars or webinars with additional recorded video or audio that could be bonuses. You could do case studies. The difference between a case study and a hot seat is before the fact. And a case study is after the fact. So you can someone can show what they did and the results they got, and then everyone can learn from what they did and their results. You could do question and answer calls. So usually if I'm doing something like this during my teleseminars or webinars, I'll be taking questions, but then I'll come back with a Q&A call afterwards. That's just nothing but questions and answers. And people love that. If you want to really build out the value of the offer, you could also offer additional one-on-one consulting calls. So everyone who buys, they get a series of, maybe they get 4 or 5 teleseminars, but they also get a 30-minute or a 20-minute or a 60-minute call with you where you can coach them individually. So that adds a lot of value to an offer. You can give them the recordings of all the calls. In fact, that's something you really should do because as I mentioned earlier, not everyone's going to show up for all your calls or all the webinars, so you definitely want to record them. And even if you weren't going to give them to people, you want the recordings so you can listen and you can assess how you did. You can offer the transcripts, so take the recordings and get them transcribed. You can usually do this. An hour transcription might cost you anywhere from $50 to $100 to get transcribed, and then you'll have to do some editing after you get the transcription back. A lot of people release transcripts without editing them at all. I personally, being the perfectionist I am, we spend a bunch of time going through and making them read very, a lot better. Because generally, the way we speak, when it gets transcribed, it just doesn't read all that well. It doesn't flow that well. So we actually try to turn them into something that's readable. Again, that's something, even if you don't release those transcripts, I like to get stuff that I record transcribed just so I can look back and see how I did, see, how I taught, see what I said. Then a really crazy thought is you could do this as a live workshop for much higher value. So if you did that, your seed launch, the pricing would usually go, we're going to talk about pricing in just a moment, but the pricing would usually go through the roof if you're going to do it as a live workshop. You know, if you're going to teach this stuff in a live environment, have people travel to you, or maybe even if you're doing it in your local environment, have them come to you, be in a room with you, and you can teach anywhere. I mean, you could teach a group of five or six people, or you could teach a group of a couple hundred people, but a seed launch, you're usually going to be teaching anywhere from, in a live environment, it'd be like probably 10 to 30 people. You get much above 30, and you're going to lose some of the interaction. But this is a way to go real high value with your seed launch. So, I mean, it's generally, if you did this, you would have a bigger list, and then you would be going for a higher price. So most of the time, the seed lists or seed launches, you're going at a very small list where maybe you just have 50 or 100 or 200 people on the list, and then you're doing one of these teleseminar-based ones. But if you were doing it as a, say you had a business where you had a large list, maybe 1,000 or 2,000 or a lot bigger, and you wanted to come up with a new product, you could do this seed launch, put a smaller group in the workshop, probably film or do at least do audio recording of the workshop, get a much higher price, and that can work very, very effectively. In fact, that's essentially what I did with my Product Launch Manager program, where I basically did it as a very high end. I took, I think, 50, was it 50 people? We took 50 primary attendees. We allowed them to bring a business partner, but I think we charged $25,000 for that. So I, I had a list of tens of thousands of people, and I offered this very, very small workshop, 50 people. By the time you added in guests and stuff, we probably had 60 or 70 people there. So we did it as a 5-day workshop. So this is, this shows where this idea of the seed launch can go to. Charged $25,000 for it. Sold it out right away because I had the big list and I had a hot list. People were on my list, loved my stuff. They're very interested in what I've got to do. And I had a very high value offer, $25,000. Went, did that event, recorded the video, and then later on turned it into a home study course. So that's how I did a seed launch at a very high level, very high dollar level, and a very impactful level, because then that home study course then went on to, sell hundreds of those at, that was like a $10,000 offer, and, just do millions of dollars with that launch. So it, these seed launch, I'm sort of, portraying it for a way to get started, but you can take the same concept and blow it out a lot bigger. Pricing. Pricing for your offer, well, it really depends on your market. If you're teaching guitar, it's going to be a lot lower price than if you're teaching salesmen who are selling medical devices or something like that. So it really depends on your market. If you can get a higher price, and again, high price is relative to your market, the high price builds value for the future product. So for instance, with that Product Launch Manager launch I did, that initial event at $25,000, that established the value going forward. And then I was able to sell the home study course for a very, very high price. Higher price usually means higher compliance. And by compliance, I mean people will actually, you want people to show up for your teleseminars and your webinars or your event, whatever you're doing, you want them to show up. And a higher price usually will motivate them to show up. it will also motivate them to do the work and get the results. However, the most important thing is to fill the class and get that critical mass. Remember, you want 30 people, you know, 30, 40, 50, 60 people. You don't want 5 people. Because if you have 5 people, you're not going to have that many people showing up. You're not going to have much interaction. So it's better to price it. If you have to price it lower to get people to show up, to get people to sign up so you can get it, have it be more interactive, then go with the lower pricing. Now, I told you about how I did it with my first product launch workshop. I sold it at a high price. Like I said, again, I can't remember if it was $2,000 or $3,000, but you know, let's just say it was $2,000. It's a high price. But I didn't sell that many, so I comped people. I let other people in for free. It wasn't like I went out to the world and said, hey, you can get in for free. I just went privately to some of my mastermind partners and some of my friends who really wanted to know this stuff, and I let them in for free. And you know, and they're pretty smart. They realize they got in for free. They realize that other people paid a lot of money, so they're not going to go and get on the calls and say, hey, Jeff, this is great. Thanks for letting me in free. People are smart that way. Or the bottom one here, I say you could do this entire thing for free. It's not ideal to do it for free because of the perceived value and because of the compliance, meaning people aren't going to take you seriously. They're not going to show up. They're not going to do the homework when you give something away for free. But it's a possibility. If you're just starting from scratch and you have no list, or you have some people that do take your stuff really, really seriously, but you don't think you can get them to pay, you could do it for free. Definitely not my preferred way to do things. So that is the offer for your seed launch.